Hi everyone, it's Emmett from Pi My Life Up. In this video, we will be showing you how you can install the Windows operating system on a Raspberry Pi. Before we get started, if you plan on using a Raspberry Pi day to day, we highly recommend that you stick with an operating system like Raspberry Pi OS. Windows is not officially supported by the Raspberry Pi team, which leads to some significant drawbacks. First off, most of the hardware functionality of the Raspberry Pi is not supported on Windows. This includes its inbuilt Wi-Fi and its Ethernet connection. To work around the network connectivity issues, you will need a USB to Ethernet adapter. You'll also need a spare USB drive that you'll install the Windows operating system to. In our case, we are using a 128GB USB drive. On top of this, we will be starting this tutorial using Raspberry Pi OS Desktop. The tools we need to use to install Windows to your Raspberry Pi run better on Linux-based operating systems. While we tested this on a Raspberry Pi 5, it should also work fine using a Raspberry Pi 4. Anything older than that will begin to really struggle with performance. Another thing we need to warn you about is that the Raspberry Pi 5 2GB and 16GB models are incompatible with some of the software required to run Windows on a Raspberry Pi. This is due to some key firmware changes that broke the UEFI BIOS that Windows relies on. Now, if you are ready to proceed, plug your spare USB drive into your Raspberry Pi and then boot into Raspberry Pi OS Desktop. If you haven't installed Raspberry Pi OS before, we'll link to a guide on this below. Once booted to Raspberry Pi OS, open the terminal by pressing Ctrl, Alt, and then T. Let us start by updating the package list cache by typing in sudo apt update and then pressing Enter. Once the package list is updated, upgrade any out-of-date packages by typing in sudo apt upgrade hyphen y and then pressing Enter. We'll next want to install Git to our Raspberry Pi. We'll be using Git to clone the latest version of the Windows on Raspberry Flasher. Install this by typing in sudo apt install git and then hyphen y. Now use Git to clone the Flasher by typing in git clone https://github.com/botspot/wor-flasher and then press Enter. Once cloned, we can launch this tool by typing in /wor-flasher/install-wor-gui.sh. This script will install any dependencies that the Windows on Raspberry Flasher requires. Once done, it will then start up the tool. The first thing we'll want to do is change the version of Windows that this tool is going to attempt to install onto our Raspberry Pi. The newer versions can have issues with the Raspberry Pis, especially the Raspberry Pi 4. To enable us to select the version of Windows we want installed, click the Windows 11 select box and then select More Options. Once that is set, click the other box and ensure that it has selected the right version of Raspberry Pi that you are running. With everything set, click the Next button. On this next screen, you'll want to select the option labeled Choose an exact Windows version to download, and then click the Next button. Now, search through this list of Windows versions and find the version labeled Windows 11 22631.2715. With this version selected, click the Next button. Next, you'll be asked to select the language that should be used for this installation of Windows on your Raspberry Pi. After selecting your language, click the Next button to continue. At this point, you should see a list of flashable storage devices connected to your Raspberry Pi. Select the one that you want to install the Windows operating system to, and then click the Next button. You'll now be prompted whether you want the Windows on Raspberry tool to just store all the files it's downloading into RAM rather than locally on your machine. We recommend selecting the option on the left-hand side. This final screen will now give you an overview of what the installer is about to do. This includes the target drive that it's going to wipe, as well as the target hardware. Ensure everything looks correct and then click the Flash button. This tool will now download Windows as well as the required software to get it running on a Raspberry Pi. Once downloaded, it will write to your chosen storage device and make it bootable. Once you see the next step screen, you can now power off your Raspberry Pi and take out the boot device that you have Raspberry Pi OS running on. In our case, this means we will remove our micro SD card and keep our USB drive plugged in. Newer versions of the Raspberry Pi do not require you to do anything for it to boot from the USB drive. However, if you are running an older Raspberry Pi and it won't automatically boot your USB drive, be sure to check out our guide on booting from a USB drive that we'll link in our description below. If everything has worked properly, you should see the Windows on Raspberry pre-installation environment appear on your screen. To begin the install of Windows to your Raspberry Pi, click the Install button. Now is the perfect time to take a long break. For us, this installation process took over an hour to complete. What we are showing within this video has been sped up by almost 10,000%. Essentially what is happening here, Windows is being installed just like it would be on any other system. This requires your Raspberry Pi to run several different things, as well as install some additional drivers. Once the install process completes, your Raspberry Pi will automatically boot into the Windows out-of-box experience. Now before we start following these install steps, we want to do something that will disable the requirements to have an active network connection to install Windows on your Raspberry Pi. Bring up the terminal by pressing Shift plus F10. Now disable the network requirement by typing OOBE in capital letters / bypass NRO, all in capital letters, and then press Enter. Your Raspberry Pi will now automatically reboot and return back to the initial Windows setup experience. On this first screen, you'll want to select your country or region. Once selected, click the Yes button to continue. Up next, you'll want to specify the keyboard layout for your connected keyboard. Once set, click the Yes button. Windows does allow you to have multiple keyboard layouts set. We aren't using this functionality, so we just click the Skip button. Next, Windows on your Raspberry Pi will attempt to establish a network connection. Unless you have connected a USB to Ethernet dongle, you will not actually have access to your network right now. Luckily, thanks to that command we used earlier, we can skip this by clicking I don't have internet. You will then be prompted that you'll be missing out on key features if you don't connect to your network. We can skip this entirely again by clicking Continue with Limited Setup. You will now be greeted with the License Agreement. If you agree to these terms, click the Accept button to continue setting up Windows on your Raspberry Pi. Next up, set a username that you intend on using to access Windows. In our case, we will use PiMyLifeUp and then we'll click the Next button to proceed. Next, we need to set a password for this account and then click Next again. Then we need to type in the password again, and then click Next yet again. As we are setting up an offline account, Windows requires us to set 3 security questions. Set each one of these and click the Next button each time to continue. This next screen allows you to turn on or off certain privacy-related features within Windows. Toggle these depending on how you want to use Windows and what sort of information you want them to have access to, then click the Next button and then click Accept. With the out-of-box experience now completed, your Raspberry Pi will now boot into the full version of Windows. At least on a Raspberry Pi 5, Windows actually feels like it's running surprisingly smooth. If it actually had proper driver support for the Raspberry Pi's many hardware functionalities, this could actually be a somewhat usable operating system. However, at least for now, the Raspberry Pi's primary operating system is always going to be Linux-based ones, such as Raspberry Pi OS and Ubuntu. If you found this tutorial to be helpful, be sure to give us a thumbs up and subscribe. Until next time, have a good one.